All right, a cult family, Patreon family. I know you're like, this bitch don't do videos very often. And the thing is, we have so much information overload. And if folks are interested in a particular topic, that you want me to cover, do y'all want me to do like some videos on demons, how to invoke jinns, working with angels or stuff? Drop it down below. Let me know. You know what I'm saying? But what I want to do is how to activate your amulet. First of all, an amulet is just an amulet, is just an amulet. You see? I have my five-pointed star. I have the dragon. I have a Rishkagal. My Ilekis, well, some of them, my Ankh. Even these that I wear. First of all, when you are going to wear any type of amulet, any type of spiritual jewelry, you have to activate it. A lot of people don't know this, but you have to activate it. It don't matter what it is, even if it's a piece of crystal. Not only does it have to be activated, but it has to be cleaned on a regular. Let's just take something like a black tourmaline, okay? A black tourmaline. Sometimes when you wear it, it cracks. You know why it cracks? Because it has absorbed so much negative energy that it buckles underneath the weight and it cracks. And then you just get another one, bless it, and charge it. So when you're about to charge any amulet, you have to charge them by the four elements: fire, water, earth, and air. And even spirit, the fifth element. So, down here, I have, let me see. So, okay. And me get this. Okay. Wow, that looked like that shorted out for a minute. So, I'm going to give you a ritual, even your Ilekis. I'm going to light fire. Incense. This is a dragon blood incense. Hathor. I need no. What, right. Okay, you can do that. Okay. Can you get me something to put this incense in? Where's the damn incense holder? You'd think I would have gotten my shit together while I'm doing this. Hold on there, peeps. This is my spiritual draw. I've got a whole bunch of crap. Or just give me one from downstairs. Okay, I got one. Okay, here we go. Okay, so I'm gonna light this incense and show the folks this ritual. I got it. Okay. And as you can see, I have a bowl of earth and I have water here. Okay. So I have all the four elements. Fire goes in the south. Earth goes in the north, air goes in the east, and the water goes in the west. You can do it any way you want to. You don't have to go by these things. Now, what I want folks to understand is that you have to bless and charge an amulet when the energy is increasing. This is where it comes in, waxing and waning. Okay, so let's just say this is a ring and this is an amber ring and you are going to wear this as a piece of jewelry for protection. Well, what you would do is you would run it through ear. Where is the Palo Santo that I got? Okay, sometime you can use Palo Santo, but what I want folks to know, a lot of the Palo Santo on the market is bullshit, okay? Because what these raggedy ass folks do is they get firewood and they chop it up and then they soak it in oil, you know what I'm saying, in scented oil. Sometimes it's even Palo Santo oil. But Palo Santo, you know, some of this can be just regular firewood that's been scented. So what I would use is Dragon's Blood, all-purpose Dragon's Blood, this brand, the Satya brand, okay? Which is very, very potent, okay? And so what you want to do, you want to go through with the fire, okay? I mean the ear. Hold on. Let me pause this for a minute. Got to get my shit together. All right, I am back. I just had to get my shit together because I swear, you know? All right, so we're gonna do the ring first. Now, this is just my personal ritual, you know? And this is ritual they do in a cult circle. Some people do it differently. Some people can make it fancy or elaborate. But I have no time for that. You understand? But one thing is you must charge your spiritual jewelry. You must charge your amulet because a lot of people run out and they buy amulet. An amulet is just an amulet, it's just an amulet. Your amulet have to be activated. So let's just say you buy a ring. And let's just say you want to use it as a spiritual ring. This one is a blue kyanite, okay? And blue kyanite is one of the crystals that help you to tap in. You know, it's one of the crystals that's good for the throat chakra. It's also for protection, you know, any kind. I wear, you know, ruby, you know, and stuff. And so you want to charge it. So you run it through some incense. You understand? This is ear. This is the energy of ear. And then you pass it through the fire. We're not saying to burn up your shit, okay? Passing it through the fire. And you invoke the spirit of fire for protection, for prosperity, for wealth. Spirit of fire for protection, prosperity, or wealth. Spirit of ear for protection, prosperity, and wealth. You know, whatever you want it to. Spirit of water, you understand? Spirit of water for spirit, for prosperity, okay? For prosperity, protection, and whatever else. If you're wearing a spiritual jewelry that you're using to attract money, then you would still use all the elements, but you would invoke that you are using this to attract spirit of wealth. You know what I'm saying? You can invoke like a spirit of wealth like Hathor, Oshun, you know, whatever. Okay, and then you do the earth last. Okay, what you can do now, normally I have a bowl of earth and I like to use bank dirt. Some people can use graveyard dirt. And what I do is I put little tiny crystals in my dirt. You know, sometimes I will sprinkle herbs in my dirt, okay? And you can put it in there, okay? Now you can do that or you can leave it overnight. Sometimes what you can do, let me get this Palo Santo, okay? Okay. And you would do that, okay? You don't have to do it with your hands. I'm, you know, that's the Rabban Jamaican, okay? And you can smoke it in the earth. You can smoke it in the earth. Spirit of earth, spirit of earth, spirit of ear, spirit of fire. Well, this in this case, this would represent ear. Okay, spirit of ear, spirit of earth, spirit of fire, spirit of water. Sometimes you don't necessarily have to put it in water. You can just pass it over the water. Okay, let me hold that down. You can just pass it over the water like so. Well, fell in the water, but you get the drift, okay? Let me get this shit, I tell you. Okay, you can just pass it over the water. Now, when you have done all of that, this is just what I like to do because the tuning fork sound vibration, you can use it and you can pass it over your stuff. You understand? You can also use this and you can, you know, you can charge your earth with it. You understand? You can charge your earth with it. Let me see. You can use a singing bowl. You understand? But this is pretty much like how you activate your spiritual amulet, even your elekis, for those people that wear elekis, okay? And I'll do another video on this with the herbs that is used, okay, to do these elekis in. And you do the same thing. You know what I'm saying? You do the same thing. You know what I'm saying? Laid over the earth, okay? Of course, these are done a little bit differently in that these are soaked in different kind of herbs like rosemary, rue, peppermint, you know, them kind of herbs. And after they're soaked in there with like Florida water and things like that, and they're prayed over, and then they're smoked out and passed and do all of this, and then you put them on. Now, here's the thing with amulets. They have to be cleaned on a regular. You see my unk? My unk has already been done. It's been passed over the fire. It's been passed over ear. You understand? It's been passed over earth and all of that. And then, like I said, the added, you know, power that you want to give it is to use a tuning fork. You understand? You hear that? And this one is actually 432 hertz. And you pass it over that. And so what you do is you awaken the metaphysical property of the stone or whatever properties of that amulet. And this is how you use it. Now, as you go through your daily life, let's just say you're wearing your amulet for a month. Typically, your amulet, you would want to keep them clean like once a month because, look, you're going to work, you're going to school, you're interacting with people, and it's protecting you. You understand? And it's also picking up energy. You understand? It's picking up energy. It's deflecting energy. It's deflecting energy away from you. So you want to keep them clear, like these bracelets that I wear. You understand? Every now and then, you know, I clean my bracelets. You understand? Well, the bracelets, there is, you can smoke them out, you know, or you can make, what I do is I make a profusion with like Florida water. I put Florida water with sea salt. I do some rosemary. I do lavender oil and a little bit of dragon's oil. And what I will do is I will just spritz. I don't have my spritz bottle. Oh, here my spritz bottle go. Okay. You see this? I use a Comet bottle. And this is Florida water. This is lavender. This is rosemary. This is some eucalyptus oil, some dragon's blood. And in the bottom, I have a shungite. And I also have a piece of moldavite, okay? Because I'm really, really on this moldavite. And so what I do is I buy little moldavites. I don't know if people can see them. But they're like little chips, okay? Hold on. Hathor! Come here. Come turn on the light for me. Just a minute there, peeps, because this place is dark. Okay. No, I don't want that goddamn fan on. Just, no. Hell no. Turn on the light for me. This light. Yes. Turn off that goddamn fan. I can't take it. Okay. All right. That's fine. Yeah. We don't want to break the fan. That's a brand new fan they just put in. Okay. Thank you. Disregard that. These are little chips of moldavite, okay? I have bigger pieces of moldavite. Let me take one out of my bra. Yes, it's ghetto, but you know, I keep moldavite in my bra. and I keep a nice little piece. You know what I'm saying? Moldavite is used to really manifest some stuff in a decent amount of time. It also amps up your meditation and all of that. So I keep that in my bra. Okay. But when I do like my rituals and I want to put them in my water, you know, I have little piece. You can also break this up with a hammer and like in two pieces. And so I have a piece in my water with a piece of shungite. Okay. So this is like I said, some dragon's blood, Florida water, regular water, sea salt, lavender, you know, rosemary, eucalyptus, peppermint, whatever kind of essential oils that I have. And what I do from time to time, like this is my bracelet, I just give it a little spritz. You understand? From time to time. You understand? Yeah. I just, you know, that just take off some energy. You understand? Because see, here is the thing that folks don't know. You have to clean your amulet from time to time, because this is something that protects you. I mean, listen, think about it. You wear your clothes, right? And another thing, that when you wash your clothes, if you really want to amp up the stuff that you wear, put a capful of ammonia in your water, okay? Put one capful of ammonia. Ammonia is a powerful psychic stripper that strips powerful psychic energy. Okay, now your clothes are ready to wear. You understand? So just like you can do your clothes, you know, because as spiritualists, we clean every goddamn thing in our house. Like summer, spring, winter, fall, we do a big ass clean of going through and smoking out and going through with the rattling, getting out any goddamn spirits. You understand? Yeah, because people come over to your house and stuff. And even though my house is dressed and stuff, you know, even friendly spirits that come in with somebody and they might like my house and want to stay. No, you got to get the hell up out of here, because I already got my own peeps up in here. You know what I'm saying? I'm not trying to take out anymore. So this is the ritual of using fire, water, earth, and air. You understand? And to amp it up, to amplify it. You understand? Either a tuning fork or a singing bowl. You understand? I know the singing bowl, you know, wakes up the properties of the earth type energy. You know what I'm saying? This is how you bless and charge your amulet. You can also put it in your hands. And if you want to recite a psalm over it after you have finished blessing it and charge it, or you want to use a mantra, like the Kali Ma mantra, Aum Klim Kali Ka Ye Namaha. You know what I'm saying? Or you can do Ankh Uje Seneb, Ankh Uje Seneb. I would do that probably about like maybe 44 times. You understand? Yeah, because you want to use master numbers. If you want to do 22, 44, whatever. You understand? You can further amplify it and imbue it. This is called imbuing it with spiritual power, okay? Because an amulet is just an amulet. You understand? And for those people that wear the Solomon keys, they are to be done in a particular time. Let's just say you have a Solomon key amulet where you, it's like the fourth or the fifth pentacle of Mars. I can't remember which one that deals specifically with protection. You would want to make sure that you do that on a Tuesday, fuck a nigga up day, when the energy is waxing. That means when the energy is increasing. Because if you do it when it's waning, that means the energy is decreasing. You can't use power. You know what I'm saying? Going for power when the energy is waning. It has to be waxing. This is why in the occult, and I'm going to get better at this, at doing videos. Because, you know, here's the thing. I'm really not a social media person, even though I have my YouTube channel and stuff. You know, I'm just not. But I want to get the information out to people. You understand? Because especially now with the craziness that's going on, we need to get our shit together quick, fast, and in a hurry. Okay? Our occult shit down. Okay? Because it's about to get crunk in this bitch. Okay? And so Now, when you are using the Solomon keys, whether you're using the Solomon key, whether it's the pentacle of Saturn, the pentacle of Mars, the pentacle of Venus, the pentacle of Mercury, the pentacle of Jupiter, they must be done on those day in that hour. So let's just say, okay, today is the moon day, Monday, and you're wearing the pentacle of the moon, okay? And depending on what pentacle, because they all serve different purposes, you want to do it in the hour. Let's just use Mars. Mars is done on a Tuesday because Mars work with the energy of Ogun. This is straight power. This is straight protection. You know what I'm saying? Against enemies and things of that nature, courage, strength, all of that. So you would want to do that on a Tuesday in a Mars hour, okay? Where it can be done either at night or morning, depending, because if you work all day, then you're going to have to do it in a Mars hour in the evening. You understand? And so this is the way that you do amulets. This is why when a spiritualist gives you an amulet, it has so much power. You know what I'm saying? And I know some people have gone to like witch doctors and, you know, they have gotten a jewelry that they want them to bless or stuff. You can do the shit yourself because you have the same power. Don't ever look at anybody because they're a witch doctor, they're a witch, they're a wizard, or they're a priest or a high priestess or whatever. Like, oh my God, they got so much power. You have the same power. That's why Jesus said, greater is in you than is in me, than is in the world. We all have the same power. We just have to know the correct rituals to do. You understand? And so this is pretty much the ritual of activating your amulet that you wear, whether it's your ankh, your cross, your rings, your ilekis, you know what I'm saying? Whatever, your beads, you understand? You have to use the four elements. The four elements, okay? And you can also invoke the four archangels, which is Gabriel, Michael, Raphael, and Uriel, that guards the four corner of the earth. It's all with you if you want to use the four demons, okay? There are four particular demons. I think there's Leviathan that deals with water, Florius, Lucifer, and somebody else. I can't remember them offhand, but it's all up to you in what you want to use. If you want to use the Orisha, if you want to use the Loa, and if you want to say a Psalms over it or a particular prayer, invoke a particular deity, it is up to you. But first, you must use the four elements. Okay? Clean your amulet first. Okay? Whether you rinse it off or whatever. And then you begin the ritual of using the elements. And this is fire in the south, earth in the north, water in the west, the incense, the air in the east. Okay? You know, these are the elemental energies that guard the four corners, okay? And so once you have charged and blessed your amulet is now ready to wear, to protect you. You understand? This is why a lot of people can't come for witches, because we got our shit blessed and charged on top of doing like the Kabbalah and stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? To shield our body, and our amulet shields us because what it does, it reflects, it deflects energies that's sent to us. You know what I'm saying? Whether mentally or somebody physically, we always have stuff that deflect. Plus, we have our spirits around us that block some shit. But we wear our amulet to deflect, okay? So this is the ritual. You got any questions? Please just drop them below and I will answer them. Let me get this, okay? So I hope you enjoyed this. This is the ritual. You understand? And you can make it as elaborate, as fancy, because some people do it real fancy and elaborate. You know what I'm saying? But basically, it's using the four element and even the fifth element of spirit, you know, by calling on spirit to bless it. You know, I use the primordial mothers, you know, I invoke like Tiamat or Amunet. You know what I'm saying? Whatever floats your boat. But the four elements have to be used to bless, to charge, and to activate your amulet. Okay? I hope you enjoyed this video. So let me know if you got any questions. All right. All right.